Hello everyone, welcome to Catalysis by Vedantu, and this is the fifth episode of this epic series, The Epic Mole. And today I'm going to give you a very interesting demonstration to remind you of something very important. Are you ready? I have this piece of paper over here, and let's say this piece of paper weighs 1 gram. Let me tear it up nice. Awesome. Now what I'll do is, I'll put it in this box. Very nice, put all the paper in the box. And now let's shake it. Now what I'll do is, let me put some salt inside this box. Yeah, I'll take this pinch of salt and in style. Very nice. Once again. Now my question to you is, very tough question, okay? What is the weight of paper inside this box? What is the weight of the paper inside the box? And you'll be like, sir, are you making a fool out of us? Obviously the weight is 1 gram, isn't it? Because the amount of paper, no matter what we did to it, was still there in the box. I just wanted to remind you of the idea of the law of conservation of mass. Do you realize that is why we balance our chemical equations? Because in chemical equations, an atom stays the same. It doesn't get converted into any other atom. It's not a nuclear reaction. If I start with 2 atoms of carbon in the beginning, the end compound that I get will still have 2 atoms of carbon. If I start with 35 grams of chlorine in the beginning, at the end, whatever product I get will still have 35 grams of chlorine. This is why we balance our chemical reactions, and that's how we are able to study stoichiometry. But what if, by using this idea of law of conservation of mass, we were able to solve questions without even balancing the equation? What if we were able to solve stoichiometry without balancing the equation by using the idea of principle of atomic conservation? So my dear friends, today's class is dedicated to this idea. Let's get back to the screen and let's try to solve some questions. See you. Alright people, welcome to Catalysis by Vedantu. My name is Pahul. I'm pretty sure you've seen details about me in the beginning of this session. So today we are going to learn how to solve these specific questions where you don't need to or you don't have to balance the chemical equation. Alright, so I hope you are ready for it. Let's get into the first question. By understanding these questions, we'll try to understand how to solve the questions of principle of atomic conservation. Okay, let's look at this first question. Very simple question. Let's try to read it. How much of CO2 and H2O can be produced by combustion of 3 grams of C2H6? Okay, great. Equation is given to us. What we can do is we can balance this equation here. We can do something and balance the equation. But what we need to learn over here is how to solve this question by not balancing it. And the idea over here is very obvious. You have to conserve some atoms. Which atoms do I need to focus on? That is the question. So over here, my dear friends, I'll give you a statement. I'll write a statement for you. Please tell me whether it makes sense or not. All carbon atoms in the final CO2 are coming from C2H6. Can I say this? All carbon atoms in the final CO2 are coming from C2H6. There is no other place. Yeah, you burn C2H6, all this carbon will get converted into CO2. Achcha. Now let us think about what's going on. Can I write 1 mole of C2H6 has 2 atoms of carbon? Yes, I can write this. 1 mole of C2H6 has 2 atoms of carbon. I can also write that 2 atoms of carbon, okay, sorry, 2 atoms of carbon can create a maximum of, or let's simply say, can create, think maximum of, 2 molecules of CO2. Yeah, if I have enough oxygen, okay, assume that you have enough oxygen, you are combusting it in air, yeah, air has enough oxygen in it already. So these two atoms of carbon, when combined with enough oxygen, can create two molecules of CO2, isn't it? Because one molecule of CO2 has one molecule of carbon in it, right? So my dear friends, combining these two statements together, can I write one mole of C2H6 can create 2 moles of CO2? And over here you can think about one molecule instead of writing one mole. One molecule of C2H6 has two atoms of carbon. Two atoms of carbon can create two molecules of CO2. So I can write over here that one molecule of C2H6 can create two molecules of CO2. Can I write that? Makes sense, isn't it? Now, whatever you've done for molecules, atoms, you can do the same thing for moles. Yeah. So, once again, read the statement carefully. We'll spend some time on this question. Then we'll move on to the next one, which is a little more complicated. One molecule of C2H6 has two atoms of carbon. Very simple. These two atoms of carbon can create two molecules of CO2. So, overall, I can say that the one molecule of C2H6 that I have in the beginning can create two molecules of CO2. Isn't it? So, my dear friends, what is the ratio of C2H6 to CO2 in this entire conversion? The ratio is 1 is to 2. Now, you must be saying, sir, isn't this the exact same thing that we do in balancing of the equations? Yes. This equation over here is easy to balance. But eventually, there would be some questions where balancing the equations would be very difficult or not possible at all. I'll show you those questions today. So, what you need to do in these cases is simply figure out the ratio of the thing that you need. You needed to understand the ratio between C2H6 and CO2, yeah, and H2O. We have that ratio, isn't it? Ye likh liya apan ne. My dear friends, let's try to write something more about this particular case, okay? Once again, I'm spending a little more time on this particular part so that further questions that are difficult become a lot easier for you. Right, so I can say that all the hydrogen atoms present in water are coming from C2H6, isn't it? That's absolutely correct. All the water molecules, the hydrogen atoms in it, are coming from C2H6. So let's write the statements over here. One molecule C2H6 has 6 atoms of hydrogen. These 6 atoms of hydrogen can create, yeah, these 6 atoms of hydrogen can create how many molecules of water? Can I say 3 molecules of water? Yeah, 2 atoms of hydrogen combined to form 1 molecule of water. So 6 atoms of hydrogen combined to form 3 molecules of water. So my dear friends, do you realize 1 molecule of C2H6 can give you 3 molecules of water? Yeah, now what we need to do is just do the calculations. Now that we have these ratios, calculations are pretty simple. Let's do them over here on this page. So you have taken 3 grams of C2H6. If I calculate the number of molecules of C2H6, I'll be able to calculate the number of molecules of CO2 and H2O respectively. Yeah, so again, moles of C2H6, molecules, moles is just a number of molecules. Yeah, I hope you understand that. So moles of C2H6 can simply be written as given weight upon molecular weight. Molecular weight is very simple. 12 into 2 is 24 plus 6 30. Chalo ji, ye to bahut simple ho gaya. Equals to 0.1 mole. So if 0.1 moles of C2H6 are present, how many moles of CO2 can I get? I can get 0.2 moles of CO2. Can you convert 0.2 mole of CO2 into mass? Absolutely, we can. So mass of CO2 can simply be written as 0.2 into molecular weight of CO2. What's the molecular weight of CO2, people? 32 plus 12, 44. So this is equal to 8.8 grams. Yes. starting from 3 grams of C2H6 and combining it with oxygen, I can get a maximum of 8.8 grams of CO2. Similarly, let's do the same thing for water. 0.1 mole of C2H6 will give me 0.3 moles of water. So what is the weight of water? Weight of H2O produced is equal to 0.3 into 18. Kitna aa gaya dosto? Very simple calculation, yes. So now do you understand how we are supposed to do this jazz? Yeah. Now do you understand how you're supposed to do this jazz? So instead of balancing the entire equation, we just looked at carbon, conserved carbon, because all the carbon will be creating carbon dioxide. We just looked at hydrogen, conserved hydrogen, all the hydrogen would be creating water. As simple as that. So these statements that we've written make a lot of sense for us. These are of a lot of significance. Please make sure you try to think of these statements in your brain. No need to write them all over the place in the examination, but at least think of these statements in the brain. In case you want to rewind and watch the process entirely once again, you can very freely do that. Now, let's jump to the next question to understand this concept a little better. Ready for the next question? Here we go. 27.6 grams of K2CO3 was treated with a series of reagents so as to convert all of it into K2 zinc 3 FeCN6. What are we doing over here? We are converting all the carbon from K2CO3 into K2 zinc 3 FeCN6 whole twice. This is the carbon over here. And in the question, it is given to us that we need to conserve carbon. This is very important, okay? So what you need to do is calculate the weight of the product. Very nice question. So what is happening over here? You are starting only with K2CO3. Carbon over here is of utmost importance. Okay, let's make carbon in a different color over here. K2CO3. Entire carbon that was present initially is now being converted into K2 zinc 3 Fe. Just a second, let me write the carbon in blue color once again. CN6 whole twice. So this carbon is what is we are conserving. We are not conserving anything else. A lot of you might be thinking, sir, why can't we conserve potassium directly? Because we are not sure whether potassium is being conserved, because there are lots of reagents in the procedure. There are lots of reagents in the procedure. Ho sakta some of the potassium I've taken away, some of the potassium is given to me from some other place, etc., etc. Yeah. So the point is that entirety of the carbon present in K2CO3 is converted into entirety of the carbon at the end in this particular product. Right? So, my dear friends, now again we have to think about the ratios, yes. If we are able to write the ratios of these things, we'll be able to figure out. So let's try to do that. I can write 1 mole of K2CO3 has 1 mole carbon atoms. Instead of thinking about molecules and atoms, let's simply think about moles. Yeah. So 1 mole of K2CO3 will have 1 mole of carbon atoms. Okay, great. Now my question to you is, how much of K2 zinc 3 FeCN6 whole twice can 1 mole of carbon create? Ye thoda weird ho gaya, yes. Let's try to think about it on a separate page. K2 zinc 3 FeCN6 whole twice. My dear friends, let's write a different statement over here. Can I write that 12 carbon atoms 12 carbon atoms are there in 1 mole or 1 molecule of this salt? Can I write that? There are 12 carbon atoms, 6 into 2, don't forget this whole twice. Yeah, 12 carbon atoms in this 1 molecule salt. There are 12 carbon atoms in 1 molecule of salt. So converting the statement into moles, I can say 12 mole carbon atoms in 1 mole salt. Yes, just multiplying both sides into 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. So now we are talking in terms of moles. Now let us divide this statement on both sides with 12. Let's divide the statement on both sides with 12 and let's write down the statement. I can say 1 mole carbon atoms are there in 1 by 12 moles of salt. Do you understand? Step by step. 12 carbon atoms in 1 molecule of salt. So 1 mole of carbon atoms in 1 by 12th mole of salt. Step by step. This is a statement that we now understand. 1 mole of carbon atoms are there in 1 by 12 moles of this salt. Let's write the statement over here. 1 mole of carbon atoms are there in 1 by 12 moles of salt. Isn't it? 1 carbon atom in 1 by 12 moles of salt. So, my dear friends, do you see this relationship right now? 1 mole of K2CO3 can give rise to 1 by 12 moles of salt. Can you see this? Yeah. So, ultimately, what you need to figure out is K2CO3 versus this salt, the ratio is 1:1/12. So, the number of moles of K2CO3 that you have in the beginning, 1/12 of that will be the number of moles of this final product. Also, the weight is given, so you can calculate the final weight as well. Isn't it? Theek hai ji? Ye toh kar lenge apan. So, let me erase all of this unnecessary information from here. Let me just keep the ratio. Theek hai? Alright, we've done it slowly, step by step. I'll repeat it once again. Listen to me carefully. 1 mole of K2CO3 has 1 mole of carbon in it. 1 mole of carbon can create 1/12 of the mole of this salt. That is why 1 mole of K2CO3 will give rise to 1/12 of a mole of this salt. Yes. Okay. So now, my dear friends, moles of K2CO3 are equal to given weight, that is 27.6, divided by molecular weight of K2CO3. Yeah. Can you people tell me the molecular weight of K2CO3 in the chat box? Whatever, se bata do. Yeah. Can you do that? K2CO3. Whatever, so you can Google it out if you want. Yeah. So the molecular weight of K2CO3 comes out to be 138. Yeah. That's what some of you are telling. Very nice. So, 27.6 divided by 138, this is the number of moles of K2CO3. So, my dear friends, what will be the number of moles of salt? 1/12 of this number. Moles of salt will be 27.6 divided by 138 divided by 12 because of the ratio. 1 K2CO3 is giving rise to 1/12 of the salt. Yes. So, now, my dear friends, simply mass of the salt is equal to moles into molecular weight, molar weight. So that is equal to 27.6 divided by 138 into 1 by 12 into 698.5. This is the calculation that we have to do. Yeah. How do we do this calculation now? थोड़ा जोर लगा लो. दैट इज वन वे टू डू द कैलकुलेशन. अदरवाइज डू यू वॉन्ट टू डू सम अप्रोक्सीमेशन? चलो आई टीच यू अप्रोक्सीमेशन राइट नाउ. सो यू कैन राइट दिस एज, ओके, गंदा अप्रोक्सीमेशन कर रहा हूं मैं, आई विल गिव यू द एग्जैक्ट आंसर एज वेल. आई एम अप्रोक्सीमेटिंग दिस एज 28 डिवाइड बाय 140 इंटू 700 डिवाइड बाय 12. दिस इज द अप्रोक्सीमेशन दैट आई एम डूइंग. ओके, सो डू यू रियलाइज नाउ देयर आर मल्टीपल things that are just divide easily divisible by 7. So this I'll write 10, this I'll write 2. So this is 280 by 24. Yeah. Or let's simply do this. This is 14. 140 by 12. 140 by 12 kitna aa gaya? 12 or fir point something around 1.2. समथिंग अराउंड 12 आ जाएगा आंसर इसका. आंसर विल बी समथिंग अराउंड 12 ग्राम्स. 140 by 12, so 10 से थोड़ा सा ज़्यादा आएगा, somewhere around 12 grams will be the answer. Ideally, the accurate answer which I have in my answer key over here is given as 11.64 grams. ठीक है जी. So this is going to be your exact answer, but in case the options in the question which are in the objective examination are far apart from each other, you know, there could be an option saying 11.64, or another option will be 22 point something, another option will be 40 something. So you can simply do the approximation and click the closest option possible. Yeah, fine. So approximation can also be done. Ganda approximation hai, but still it works at times. Fine people, got it. So this is how you do principle of atomic conservation. We have conserved the carbon atom over here very beautifully. Let's do one more question for principle of atomic conservation. Jitne question karenge utna maza aayega. Acha, we'll do that question after this one. This is your homework question from the previous class, people. Do you remember? In every class I give you homework question, and this is the homework question from the previous class. So people, very simple question over here. The equation that is given over here is already balanced. Okay, so what mass of CaCO3 is required to react with 25 milliliters of 0.75 molar HCl? Dekho, bahut simple sa question hai. Let's try to do it over here. So do you realize the ratio of moles of CaCO3 versus HCl is 1:2? Yeah, if you have 2 moles of HCl, you need 1 mole of CaCO3. If you have X moles of HCl, you need X by 2 moles of CaCO3. So over here, can I understand moles of HCl are equal to how much? Moles of HCl are equal to molarity into volume, that is equal to 0.75 into 25 by 1000. Why did I do this? Because I have to take the volume in liters for moles. Otherwise, I could have simply written this. Yeah. Milliliters multiplied with molarity gives you millimoles. Milli is simply 10 to the power minus 3. Yeah. So instead of writing millimoles, I could also write 25 by 1000 moles, because molarity is defined by moles per liter. So take the volume in liters. ठीक है जी, चलो ये हो गया. So over here, moles of CaCO3 will be equal to half the number of moles of HCl. That's the ratio that is given over here. So moles of CaCO3 will be half into 0.75 into 25 by 1000. Right? So what will be the weight of CaCO3? Weight of CaCO3 will be equal to half into 0.75 into 25 by 1000 into molecular weight of CaCO3. Molecular weight of CaCO3 kitna hota hai? We've done it in some earlier questions in previous classes as well. CaCO3's molecular weight is simply 100. As simple as that. There is nothing complicated about it. Now it's just about calculation, people. Yeah, so I can write this as 75 into 25 by 100 into 2 into 10, hai na? Likh sakta hu main. So this comes out as 4. 4 into 2 is 8. So this is 75 by 80. Somewhere around 0.9 kuch aa jayega na answer. Yeah. So somewhere around 0.9 something aa jayega answer. So now what I'll do is, instead of writing the exact answer over here, let me check out the comment section of the previous class to see who has given the correct answer. Yeah. So just give me 1 second. Let me open the comment section from the previous class. All right, so here it is. Comment section of the previous class. Please make sure you watch this class if you haven't already. It's a very beautiful class on problems of concentration of solutions. Very important class once again. So I have sorted the comments by newest first. So the oldest comments, which were the fastest on the video, will come at the end. Let us try to open that up. काफी लोगों ने सही आंसर दिया है. 0.935 इज द करेक्ट आंसर. 0.9375, वेरी नाइस. सो सतीयुष, वेरी गुड मैन, फेवरेट सॉन्ग इज या अली. विशाल, वेरी गुड जॉब. योगेंद्र, वेरी गुड जॉब. बायो कुलदीप, वेरी गुड जॉब. नलिन, वेरी नाइस, वेरी नाइस. अभय प्रताप, गुड जॉब मैन. यू कैन रीड द फेवरेट सॉन्ग्स इज वेल. वे माही, जेरिको आइलैंड, ऑल इज वेल. खुशबू इज गिविंग द करेक्ट आंसर. मेरी आश की फेवरेट सॉन्ग. अभय वेरी नाइस मैन. शिवांश वेरी गुड जॉब. मैडी गुड गुड गुड. ब्रो यू डिड सम वियर्ड मिस्टेक. ओके प्लीज सॉल्व इट अगेन. पशुमारती ओके ग्रेट मैन. फाइन यू कुड हैव कन्वर्टेड इन टू द डेसिमल बट दैट्स फाइन. योर कैलकुलेशन इज एब्सोल्युटली फाइन. रफिया आयुष अंशुल गुड जॉब मैन. शुभ येस ऑलमोस्ट देयर. आई मीन या यू अप्रोक्सीमेटेड करेक्टली. सौम्या वेरी नाइस. सो पीपल अ लॉट ऑफ यू गेव मी द करेक्ट आंसर. आई हैव टेकन द नेम्स ऑफ अ फ्यू ऑफ यू. सो वेरी गुड जॉब पीपल. कीप इट अप. इफ योर नेम वॉज देयर गिव मी अ हाई फाइव इन द चैट बॉक्स. एंड इन केस यू वर एबल टू सॉल्व दैट क्वेश्चन करेक्टली डजेंट मैटर वेदर योर नेम वॉज देयर डजेंट मैटर वेदर योर नेम वॉज स्पोकन. इफ यू डन द क्वेश्चन करेक्टली वेरी गुड जॉब प्राउड ऑफ यू. चलो जी सो नाउ लेट्स गेट बैक टू द POAC प्रिंसिपल ऑफ एटॉमिक कॉन्जर्वेशन एंड लेट्स ट्राई टू फिगर आउट द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन. वेरी ब्यूटिफुल क्वेश्चन वंस अगेन. ठीक है. What's given is NaH2PO4 which is being combined with NH4 positive and Mg2 positive. Ye Mg ka positive niche chala gaya. I'll write it over here. Yeah. It gives something 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 something. Okay, great. Then you heat it up. Then you also get Mg2P2O7. Okay, great. My dear friends, from the starting point to the end point, what is the atom that I can conserve? From the starting point to the end point, can you tell me what is the atom that I can conserve? Because balancing this reaction is practically impossible. Yeah, too much given over here. Is sodium present in the final mixture? No. So I can't think about sodium. Is hydrogen present in the final mixture? No. Is phosphorus present in the final mixture? Phosphorus can be used, I guess. Is oxygen present in the final mixture? Yes, but do you realize that inside the reaction, more oxygen is coming in by water? Yeah, more oxygen is coming from water. So all the oxygen in the final compound is not coming from the initial part. It might be coming from water molecules as well. So you need to be judicious. You need to choose very carefully which atom to think of conserving. Yeah. कौन सा एटम कंजर्व करने के लिए सोचना है. विच एटम हैज टू बी कंजर्व्ड. दैट इज समथिंग दैट यू हैव टू बी रियली रियली थॉटफुल अबाउट. सो लेट्स कंजर्व द फॉस्फोरस एटम्स ओवर हियर. ठीक है. सो व्हाट द क्वेश्चन सेज इज इफ 1.054 Mg2P2O7 इज फॉर्मड एट द एंड ऑफ द रिएक्शंस, व्हाट वेट ऑफ NaH2PO4 वॉज प्रेजेंट ओरिजिनली. तो बस रेशो निकल गया. इफ यू नो देयर मोलर रेशोज देन वेट कैलकुलेशंस कैन बी डन इजीली. सो वंस अगेन लेट्स राइट दिस स्टेप बाय स्टेप. ओके आई विल ट्राई टू राइट एज नीट एज पॉसिबल. वन मोल ऑफ NaH2PO4 हैज वन मोल ऑफ फॉस्फोरस एटम. Yes, and one mole of phosphorus atoms, as you can see over here, can give you how much Mg2P2O7? अच्छा उसको समझने के लिए let's write it like this: 2 mole of phosphorus atoms can give me 1 mole of Mg2P2O7. Yeah, you need 2 mole of phosphorus atoms for 1 molecule of this. Yeah. So 2 mole phosphorus atoms give me 1 mole of Mg2P2O7. So 1 mole of phosphorus atoms will give me how much? They will give me 0.5 mole of Mg2P2O7. Absolutely simple. If 2 give me 1, then 1 will give me 0.5. कोई मुश्किल ही नहीं है इसमें. Yes. So now, my dear friends, we have the ratio. We have the ratio that 1 mole of NaH2PO4 is giving you 0.5 mole of Mg2P2O7. Or I can also write something like this. Okay, or I can also write that the ratio of NaH2PO4 versus Mg2P2O7 is simply 2:1 ratio. instead of writing 1:1/2 ratio, let's simply write 2:1 ratio. Yeah. So 2 moles of NaH2PO4 will form 1 mole of Mg2P2O7 at the end. Inversely, if 1 mole of Mg2P2O7 is created at the end, 2 moles of NaH2PO4 would have been there initially. Right? Very simple idea. Now that we have molar ratios, let's convert the mass into moles and then let's do the calculation. So, my dear friends, in this question, moles of, let me do this in blue color. So, moles of, I'm just writing MOLS to make it shorter. Moles of Mg2P2O7 are equal to how much? Given weight, that is 1.054 divided by molecular weight of Mg2P2O7. Tell me, people, what is the weight? I'm trying to figure that out from the chat box. Yeah, chat box mein bata do, what's the weight of Mg2P2O7? Karo, calculate. You can Google it out for now. No need to worry about these huge weights. So a lot of you must be asking right now that, sir, do we need to remember these weights? No. Do we need to remember the molecular weights of these different molecules? Practically speaking, no. Because number one, when you will practice such questions again and again, molecular weights will get embedded in your brain. Let's say you do 20 questions of the mole concept chapter for stoichiometry. In all of those 20 questions, there will be some weight or the other. Yeah, some of them will be repeated. Let's say you do 3 questions in which the weight of sodium was being used. So after doing these questions, your brain will automatically retain the weight of sodium as 23. Yeah. So number one, how to memorize these weights? Solve more questions. Number two, in examinations like J Advanced, sometimes in J Mains and NEET as well, whenever there are masses which are, you know, not very common, they give it to you next to the question. Okay. So jaise yahan pe, if this question was asked in J Advanced, they would give you the weight of phosphorus and magnesium. Okay. If this question was asked in NEET, they might expect you to remember the masses. So the best way to remember masses is to do more and more questions. Okay. So up tak, I am pretty sure a lot of you would have calculated the mass. The mass comes out to be 222 grams per mole. Yes. Comes out to be 222 grams per mole. So this is the number of moles of Mg2P2O7. Okay. So my dear friends, moles of NaH2PO4 will be equal to 2 times that number. Yeah. So that will be 1.054 divided by 222 into 2. This is the moles of NaH2PO4. So if you have to convert moles into mass, then what will you do? Mass of NaH2PO4 is just moles of NaH2PO4. Yahan pe maine P4 likh diya, sorry. Yeah. Mass of NaH2PO4 will be moles of NaH2PO4 into molecular weight of NaH2PO4. The molecular weight kitna hai dosto, again do a little bit of calculation. Yeah, if you do the calculation, you will get 120. Theek hai ji? Again, no need to remember all of these things. You can calculate them on the spot. And how do you remember the masses of individual atoms? By doing more and more calculations and more questions. Theek hai ji? So this is what you have to do over here. This is the calculation that you need to do. So this will be 111 ho jayega yahan pe. So 1.054 into 120 by 111. Yeah. So this will be 120 by 111. Approximately 1 ke aas paas hi kuch aayega na, 1.1 something. Yeah. So 1.054 into 120 is approximately 120. 120 divided by 111. 111 se 120 gaya. 10 bacha, approximately 1.1, yes. So approximation is 1.1 grams. Exact answer which you will get, which I have in my answer key, is going to be 1.139 grams or 1.14 grams. Theek hai ji? So this will be your exact final answer for this question. So once again, very simple idea. You have to conserve the phosphorus atom over here, which you have to choose very carefully. Okay, so principle of atomic conservation is not an option. It's not like you can always do by balancing equation, but POAC is something different. No, POAC is important. Why is PUAC important? Because if such questions come, then you can't balance the equation at all. And such questions are very, very, very common in examinations, especially like examinations of JEE Advanced. Okay. So JEE Advanced, mein, whatever questions they'll ask from stoichiometry, it will involve principle of atomic conservation somewhere or the other. All the questions that come from redox reactions and ionic equilibrium use this concept quite a lot. So this concept is very important. In case you joined the class late, watch it from the beginning. In case you skipped some parts of the class, watch it entirely. You can watch it at a higher speed if you want. And you can watch the questions 2-3 times to get a perfect understanding of these questions. Got it? Fine. Awesome. So my dear friends, now that we've spent around half an hour understanding about principle of atomic conservation, now let's jump on to the next topic of today's class, and that is the empirical formula. Empirical formula. Okay. Now, some of you, I'm pretty sure, have done this idea in 9th or 10th class, depending on whatever board you are in. Yeah. First of all, I would like to ask you a question. My question is, what is the meaning of the word empirical? Ye jo word hai, empirical. What is the meaning of this word? Can you tell me quickly? What's the meaning of this word? Soch liya. A lot of you would be saying, sir, empirical means simplest. Empirical means smallest. Empirical means simplest ratio. Empirical means this, that, so on and so forth. My dear friends, empirical, the word empirical stands for experimental. Okay? The word empirical stands for experimental. Alright, let's say you make dal khichdi every day, okay, and you figure out that for one cup of dal and one cup of rice, the best amount of salt that you can put is four teaspoons, okay. So you realize that when you are creating khichdi, when you are using one cup of dal and one cup of water, you have to put four teaspoons of salt to make it taste good. This is a ratio that I have calculated in my kitchen, by the way. So, my dear friends, do you realize that this is an experimentally determined idea? Yeah, you didn't do molecular research on dal and chawal to figure out how much salt it needs. You just did some experiment in your kitchen and figured out experimentally that you need 4 teaspoons if you have 1 cup of rice and 1 cup of dal. This observation can be called an empirical observation. Empirical means something that is determined from an experiment. So how does it refer to the empirical formula that we all have read and understood in earlier classes? See, what happens is, in old days, when people used to do calculations, when people used to try and figure out the formula of something, what they could do is they could calculate the mass of this atom, mass of this atom, mass of this atom. That is all they could do. Yeah, they could say that this has 50 grams of carbon, 50 grams of hydrogen, 100 grams of oxygen, so on and so forth. Yeah. So now from the mass, do you realize they can calculate only the simplest ratio? From the mass, they can only calculate the simplest ratio. They can't calculate the complicated ratio if it is C2H5O7. I mean, if it is C2H2O8, simplest ratio is something that you can obtain. Let me solve this question for you, and then we'll understand why we can get only the simplest ratio and why we don't get the molecular formula in the first go. So, the thing is that when you did an experiment on a certain compound which had carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, this is the composition that you get. Percentage composition of the mass in that sample you got is 40% of mass of that sample is carbon, 6.67% of the mass of that sample is hydrogen, 53.33% of the mass of that sample is oxygen. All right. Imagine a 100 gram sample. Okay. Imagine a 100 gram sample, isn't it? Easiest imagination. So do you realize that 40% of 100 is 40? So yeah. So imagine that in the 100 grams of sample, 40 grams is carbon, 6.67 grams is hydrogen, and 53.3 grams is oxygen. Right. Now, my dear friends, can you calculate the number of atoms of each of these? Calculate the number of atoms of each of these. How will we calculate the number of atoms of each of these? Given a weight upon atomic weight. That's what we've been doing till now. Yes, given weight upon atomic weight. So number of atoms of carbon will be how much? 40 divided by 12. Number of atoms of hydrogen will be 6.67 divided by 12. Number of atoms of oxygen will be 53.33 divided by 16. And when I'm saying atoms, please understand I'm talking about moles of atoms over here, because these are in grams. Okay, 6.67 atoms does not make sense, but 6.67 moles of atoms makes perfect sense. Yes. So whenever I'm saying atoms over here, I mean moles of atoms, because weights are in grams. If you don't understand what's the difference between the weight of an atom and the weight of one mole of atoms, please watch the very first class of the epic mole. Right? Chalo. So my dear friends, can you do this calculation fatafat se? Yahan pe calculation kar lete hain. Let me just rewrite things on the top. You do your calculation until then. Fatafat se batao. तो मैं यहीं पे लिखूंगा साथ ही में. लेट मी क्रिएट अ बॉक्स लाइक दिस वंस अगेन. कूल. सो 40 अपॉन 12 कितना आ जाएगा? 12 इंटू 3 इज 36. फिर 4 बच गया, फिर 36. सो दिस विल बी 3.333 समथिंग. या अच्छा, यहाँ पे मैंने गलती कर दी. यहाँ 12 लिख दिया मैंने. आई एम वेरी सॉरी अबाउट दैट. 1 हाइड्रोजन्स मास इज 1. सिली मिस्टेक फ्रॉम माई साइड. वेरी सॉरी. Yeah, so this will come out to be 6.67 only. Great. And finally for oxygen, 16, 53.3. 16 into 3 is 48. 48 ke baad agar main bachaunga 53 kitna aa jayega? वहीं बात आ गई फिर से, है ना. सो दिस विल ऑल्सो कम आउट टू बी 3.33333 समथिंग. यस. नाउ माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, कैन वी कैलकुलेट अ रेशियो आउट ऑफ दिस? हाउ कैन वी कैलकुलेट अ रेशियो? सी द रेशियो ओवर हियर इज वेरी सिंपल टू सी, इजंट इट? 3.33, 6.67, 3.33. या सो द रेशियो ओवर हियर आई एम प्रिटी श्योर इज वेरी सिंपल. द सिंपलेस्ट रेशियो, the simplest ratio would be 1:2:1. How did we calculate this ratio? Essentially take the smallest amount that is present over here, okay, smallest amount of the atoms, and divide everything with that smallest amount. So what am I essentially doing in order to get the ratio is dividing all of these places by 3.33. yeah, 3.33 is the smallest number in the atoms column. Yeah. So divide all of them by 3.33, you will get the simplest ratio. So my dear friends, the empirical formula can be written as C1H2O1. So my dear friends, in reality, this could be C6H12O6. Sugar ka formula dikh raha hai. This could also be C2H4O2. So the thing is that from the simplest ratio that we obtain, we could get a bunch of different possibilities of compounds. In old days, all we could do is we could do this calculation to get the simplest ratio. There was no other way to figure out the complicated ratio unless I did some other experiment. Okay, I would do some other experiment. I would try to figure out what's the weight of one molecule of this substance, etc., etc., and then maybe things will help me. Okay. But right now, I hope you realize that I can only get the simplest ratio from this type of an experiment. That is why it is known as an empirical formula. Okay? Okay. So we have understood how to figure out the simplest ratio. This is something that you've done in earlier classes as well. Let us try to do a question related to this, which involves a little bit of POAC as well. And then we'll be able to understand this concept a little better. Let's move on to this question. Let's read it out. A welding fuel gas contains only carbon and hydrogen. Burning a small sample gives 3.38 grams of CO2, 0.69 grams of H2O, and no other products are formed. So do you realize it combines some POAC over here? Yeah. All of the carbon from the beginning is coming into CO2. All of the hydrogen from the beginning is coming into H2O. So POAC comes over here. Great. Also, volume of 10 liters measured at standard temperature and pressure is this much. Calculate the EF बोले तो empirical formula, MM बोले तो molecular mass, MF बोले तो molecular formula. All right, so we have to calculate the empirical formula, molecular mass, molecular formula, and there is this weird piece of information given to us here. 10 liter is 11.6 grams. I'll tell you about this as well. Step by step, we will solve this particular question. We'll do it a little faster, okay? Please pay a lot of attention. 3.38 grams of CO2. Can I calculate the moles of CO2 straight away? Moles of CO2 is equal to, moles of CO2 are equal to given weight, that is 3.38 grams, upon molecular weight, that is 44. This is the moles of CO2. And do you realize that this is also the number of moles of carbon? Yeah, because CO2 has one carbon atom in it. So this is the number of moles of carbon that are coming from the initial part. Okay, great. Also, can we write moles of H2O are equal to 0.69 divided by 18. Now, my dear friends, this multiplied with 2 will give me moles of hydrogen, isn't it? Because there are 2 moles of hydrogen and 1 mole of water, right? So, my dear friends, over here I have moles of carbon and I have moles of hydrogen, isn't it? I have 2 numbers over here. One is the moles of carbon, one is the mole of hydrogen. If I take their ratio, do you realize I will get a very simple whole number ratio? Do you understand that? If I take the ratio of these two guys, I will get a simple whole number ratio, isn't it? So, finally, tell me in the chat. So finally, tell me in the chat box what will be the answer over here. Finally, tell me in the chat box what will you get. Okay, thodi si calculation karni hai aapko. So, 3.38 divided by 44. 11 se agar main karta hoon, 11, 3, 11, 4. 3 by 4. Somewhere around 0.7 aayega ye wala. Somewhere around 0.7. The other calculation that is there, 0.69 divided by 9. So 9.7. Ye bhi 0.7 kuch hi aa raha hai na? This is also coming out to be 0.7. Somewhere. So, if you do the exact calculation, you'll realize both the numbers are pretty much equal to each other. Okay. Sorry, I have 0.7 likh diya yahan pe. It'll be 0.07. In my approximate calculation, I just thought of the number 7. Yeah. So, exact calculation, agar aap karoge, so you'll get the number 0.07. Very simple. Yeah. So, my dear friends, over here, do you realize that the simplest whole number ratio, the simplest whole number ratio will be C0.07, H0.07, essentially the simplest whole number ratio is C1H1, isn't it? This, my dear friends, is the empirical formula. Yeah. So this question used the idea of principle of atomic conservation. Yeah. So, moles of CO2 is equal to moles of carbon, moles of H2 divided by 2, sorry, moles of H2O multiplied by 2 is equal to moles of hydrogen, and you were able to get this calculation for both of these. Theek hai? So, the simplest whole number ratio for the moles of carbon and hydrogen comes out to be C1H1. Great. Now comes the idea of how to calculate the molecular mass and molecular formula. Chalo, ye yahan pe kya diya hai? That 10 liters measured at STP. STP is standard temperature and pressure. So, my dear friends, this is an idea from gaseous state chapter. Okay. Details will be later. Details about this idea will be shared later in the chapter of gaseous state, but right now what you need to remember is that at standard temperature and pressure, STP bolo to standard temperature and pressure, where temperature is 273 Kelvin and pressure is equal to 1 bar. Okay, 1 bar is approximately equal to 1 atm. So at standard temperature and pressure, 1 mole of an ideal gas. Okay, 1 mole of an ideal gas. What is ideal gas? We'll think about it in gaseous state, but for now, any gas that you have in calculations, think about it as an ideal gas. 1 mole of ideal gas is equal to 22.4 liters in volume. Okay, this is an idea that comes from the gaseous state chapter. There is an equation called PV equals to nRT. When we solve it for 1 mole at standard temperature and pressure, we realize that 1 mole of a gas will occupy 22.4 liter of volume. Okay, this is an idea applicable for ideal gases. So 1 mole of a gas is equal to 22.4 liter of volume. So over here, what is given? 10 liter is this much. Achha, theek hai. So the information that is given to me is 10 liter is equal to 11.6 grams. So my dear friends, I can write 1 liter is equal to 11.6 divided by 10 grams. So can I write the volume? Can I write the mass for 22.4 liters? Obviously I can. 11.6 divided by 10 into 22.4. Yes. Can we do this calculation? Fatafat se kar lenge calculation. Yeah. So this comes out to be how much? 11.6 into 22.4. 1.16 into 22.4. Yes. 25 se thoda zyada aayega. It'll be a little more than 25. I think the exact should be 26 grams. You can do the calculation. You will get somewhere very close to 26 grams. ठीक है, सो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, 22.4 लीटर इज व्हाट? 1 मोल. सो व्हाट इज गिवन ओवर हियर इज दैट 1 मोल ऑफ दिस गैस वेज 26 ग्राम्स. अच्छा, तो नाउ लेट अस डू अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ लॉजिकल रीजनिंग. माय एम्पिरिकल फॉर्मूला इज सी एच. व्हाट इज द मास ऑफ सी एच? मास इज इक्वल टू 13. My molecular mass is equal to 26. So my dear friends, do you realize that this CH will be present twice in one molecule? Implies I have this empirical formula two times in the molecule, right? So my dear friends, molecular formula is equal to how much? C2H2. And if you know a little bit about organic chemistry from your 10th class, you would realize that this is nothing but ethane gas. Yes, let's revisit this question once again. So hua kya yahan pe? Moles of CO2 will give you moles of carbon, moles of H2O multiplied by 2 will give you moles of hydrogen. The ratio of these moles is essentially coming from the original fuel gas. And the empirical formula for that comes out to be C1H1 when we take the ratio of these two calculations. Now, new concept that I told you is that from gaseous state, you need to remember that 1 mole of a gas is equal to 22.4 liters in volume. Over here, it is given that 10 liters is equal to 11.6 grams. So 22.4 liters is equal to 26 grams. Yeah, 10 liter, 11.6 grams. So 1 mole will be coming out as 26 grams. So if I have the weight of 1 mole of the formula, if my empirical formula is giving me the mass as 13, I need 2 times this empirical formula to give the mass of 1 molecule. Yes. So just multiply this entire empirical formula into 2 and this is what you will get. Molecular formula is C2H2. Very logical idea, yeah? ठीक है जी. सो दिस इज हाउ इन ओल्ड डेज मॉलिक्यूलर फॉर्मूला वर कैलकुलेटेड. डिड सम एक्सपेरिमेंट वॉज एबल टू कैलकुलेट द रेशियो ऑफ एटम्स. देन डिड सम अदर एक्सपेरिमेंट वॉज एबल टू कैलकुलेट द मास ऑफ 1 मोल. देन कंपेयर्ड विद ईच अदर एंड फिगर्ड आउट वॉट इज द फाइनल मॉलिक्यूलर फॉर्मूला. गॉट इट? Very nice. And once again, you can revisit these questions again by rewinding a little bit and watching the class. Cool. So now, my dear friends, comes the time when I will give you the homework for the next class. Okay, this is the homework for the next class. And when will the next class happen? The next class is going to happen on Tuesday at 7 p.m. And in that class, we will learn about the equivalent concept. That's also very, very, very important for further chapters like redox reactions and ionic equilibrium. So to understand equivalent concept is 210% important. Please make sure you join me on Tuesday at 7 p.m. for that class. Let me try to give you some ideas on how to solve this question. A sample of a mixture of CaCl2 and NaCl weighing 4.22 grams. So there's a mixture which has both of these and it weighs 4.22 grams. It was treated to precipitate all the calcium as calcium carbonate. So all the calcium in this mixture, which is present over here, is converted into CaCO3, which is then heated and quantitatively converted to 0.959 grams of CaO. Essentially, all the calcium was taken from the beginning, something, converted into CaO. Similar to the questions that we've done. CaCl2, something, all of its calcium converted to CaO and the weight of that is given. So from this, I'm pretty sure you'll be able to calculate the moles of calcium. If you have the moles of calcium, you have the moles of CaCl2. If you have the moles of CaCl2, you have the weight of CaCl2. And by that weight, you have to calculate the percentage of CaCl2 in the total mixture. Cool. So this is the homework for the next class. You have to answer me in the comments. Okay, after the video is over, open the comment section and answer in the comment box down below. I mean, it's a premiere, so I'm pretty sure you can access the comment box already. So answer in the comment section down below and also tell me what is your favorite. I always don't know what to ask you about. What is your favorite? What's your favorite dessert? Okay, dessert bolo to what meetha do you like to eat? Don't tell me thar dessert, please. What dessert do you like? So, for example, I like to eat fruits, mango especially as a dessert. Or I really like to have kheer and rabdi, all sorts of things. Yeah. So, what is your favorite dessert? You guys have to tell me. Some people will say chocolate brownies. That's also a good thing to eat, by the way. I mean, tasty thing to eat, not really healthy. Cool. So people, in case you want more details on other chapters, if you want to learn those on Vedantu's patented platform, then please go down in the comment section, also in the description box. The details of micro courses are given. Those courses are available just for ₹1, and that ₹1 is just a formality. It allows you to join Vedantu as a regular student for one specific chapter so that you can try out what Vedantu feels like. Yeah, so all the material of that chapter will be given. You will get live classes of that chapter. All those live classes will be recorded that you can watch later, doubt solving, etc., etc. So just to get a taste of what Vedantu feels like in its paid courses, these micro courses are available to you. Just go down and register. The fees is just ₹1. Very simple. Cool. So my dear friends, I hope you enjoyed today's class. In case you did, please hit that thumbs up button. And I will see you once again very soon on this channel. Stay tuned until then. Stay subscribed. Thank you so much. Ciao.